Like, subscribe and press the bell icon for more videos from PHN Learn. For more videos, download our app from the Play Store.
Hello everyone, welcome back to the HTML and CSS tutorial by PHN Technology Private Limited. So in this tutorial, we are going to create a footer for our website, and that's how we complete the website. Now, what does a footer basically do in our website? It stores all the contacting information about us, or the visitor can leave his or her contact information in there. Also, we put in their addresses, codes, about our website a little bit, and things like that. So what we are going to do is, we are going to create a form for the visitor to fill in his details. Also, we are going to enter our social media platform details over there through icons. And then we are going to enter the small menu which is available inside our navigation bar. And the final thing would be a little bit of code and about our website, like what we can do for them. Okay, so this was what we are going to do in the footer. So let's start with the coding. Now, to create a footer, we use the tag footer itself. Now, this particular tag was introduced in HTML5. So the footer is a paired tag. Now, some people say that the footer should come outside the body. No, it is not necessary. It should come inside the body since it is the content of our website. So, I'm going to enter some content over here. Now, I mentioned four different sections inside my footer. So, either you can use the section thing, or you can use a table, or you can create a table using the div tags. So, we are going to do the third option, that is, we are going to create a table using the div options. Because table kind of creates some kind of restrictions, and it would restrict our spacing and things, different things. When you use table and you compare it with this method, you'll find the restrictions, okay? So div, I'm going to give my class. Now, if I use the previous class name, like row, I have used row so many times in the previous tutorials. But what was happening is, what will happen is, it will take the, it is like we are calling that class again over there, right? So it would take the styling of the previous class wherever we have used it, okay? Wherever you have, we have used that particular class name. So if you don't want it to adapt to the class properties of that particular class, what you can do is, you can give a different name, just like I'm giving row 4. Now you can see how many class names I have given. I have actually changed the class names over here because it was adapting to the previous styling and it was creating some problems for me. So what have I done is, I have given class and row name differently to every section. So here I am. Now I have created a row. I am going to create the columns now. So I am going to require four columns, right? So I'm going to copy this and paste this four times. So here are my four columns. My first column is going to have the form, that is the contact us form. So I've entered like the H4 tag over here, and inside this I'm going to write contact us. Then my second column is going to have the menu. Okay, so I'm going to enter H4 over here again, and I'm going to enter menu. My third thing is going to have little bit of details about my website, like let's just say about my website. Okay, I'm not entering the heading because we are directly going to enter a quote or something like that, and then we will enter the information. Okay, the fourth thing I'm going to enter is my social media accounts. You can say H4 as contact us. Now we can change the name of this as we will contact you, right? Because it is going to have a form. So we just save it and see how it is going to look. Now this is a basic structure, so it is going to look quite plain in there, right? You can see it has appeared. Now what do we want? We want it side by side. So we need to give the coding for row and column over here, and we will also give some styling to our footer as well. So my footer, I'm going to give it some background color as RGBA 215. 215 is for gray, right? Now, as you will use colors and create more websites, you'll acknowledge a lot of colors, and all these numbers of the colors would be learned by you automatically. Okay. So 0.6. Then I'm going to tell it to stick it to the bottom. So let's just save this and see what is happening. Now, since we have given them inside the row and column, they are not going to come side by side automatically. We have to code about them. So it has come. You can see it hasn't stick to the bottom. So we will do something about it. First, let's just enter about column. Okay. First, we'll enter column 4. We will enter float left. We have done this so many times. Then we will define its width. Now the columns are divided into 4. So the width would be defined accordingly, right? So I am right now giving it as, let's just say, 30%, okay? And after this, I am going to enter for row. And I am going to give it a selector. That is my pseudo class selector as after. And inside this, I'm going to enter content as nothing. And then we will say display as table. And after that, we will say clear both. That is, there will, if, even if the float, it would not float in the both the sides. Floating would be cancelled over here. So I've saved it, and now we'll refresh it. So it's taking time. Now in the nav bar, you can add the contact us page, which would redirect to the nav bar over there. Now if you want to add that, you can do that. So it has come in here. Now you can see the contact us is coming over here. So what do we need to do is, we need to decrease the width of our particular footer. So we will inspect it using the Control Shift I option. So we'll just change, I think I have entered the spelling over here wrong, contact, okay, and then select this particular using the select the element option. We'll just select this, or we'll just go in the footer over here and select the column, right, because we need to decrease the width of the column. So let's just see how much do we want it to be, so that the contact us should come over here. So here it is, we need it to be 24%. Let's just try to increase it some. Okay, so it can be 25% actually. Obviously, if we divide 100 divided by 4, how much it would be? It would be 25%. So we'll just go inside the footer and name it as 25%. Save it. Now we will add the form in here. But before that, we need to add the copyright over there, right? Do you remember that every website down has copyright to 2020 and the company's name? So even we need that. So what are we going to do is, we will create another footer over here. Now you can use the footer tag as many times as you want to inside your website, okay? You can have footer for every section as well. So I'm going to enter some content. So it would be @ for copyright, the C icon, the C symbol, I'm going to use @ copy. And after this, I'm going to write copyrights 2020 and whatever your name is, write your name over here, technology. And I'm going to give, I'm going to give the styling over here only. I'm going to use the inline styling. Since we have used footer two times, we have to give a particular class to the second one, right? So I'm just going to use style over here, okay? And the inline styling. And then I'm going to give it some background color as black. And then I'm going to tell it to align the text in the center. And I'm going to save it. So as soon as I refresh it, I'm going to find the copyright over here. Now you can decide the width of it also. So we will define the width also here. the width, or let's just say the height, sorry. The width would be like this. So we need to define it height as, let's just say 100 px. You can decrease or increase the size of this using the height. Okay, so now this particular copyright, you can see the copyright symbol has appeared over here. Now let's just work on the main footer of our website. So this is our main footer, and we will create a form. To create the form, we use the basic tag as form first of all, and inside there you will find two components. The first would be the label, that is the name, whatever filling we have to do, and second would be the input. Okay, like if you enter name and then you give some space for the visitor to enter the name. So to enter this name, we use the tag label over there, and to take the input, we use the type input. Okay, now the input here can be in many types. It can be a radio button, right? It can be a button as well, like whatever, when you want to submit that particular form, what do? You take the input of the user, right? So also we create the buttons in there using the input only. Okay, the input has so many types over here, and we learn about them in the upcoming tutorials. Or let's just have a little bit of task for you. Why don't you explore all kinds of input types over here? You can find radio buttons, you can find checkbox over there. So let's just try all these inputs, and please tell us in the comment section that what was the most interesting one. Okay, so we'll just create a simple form over here which will have a label. Inside this we write label for. Now what does this for give? We give an ID name over here. Now what does this ID do? For this particular name, it takes the input value and stores this in the database. So this database can be created using PHP, which we'll learn in the upcoming tutorials. So I'm going to give a ID name over here, like I'm going to give name. Okay, after this we need to display that this particular label is for name, right? So this is how our label has been created. Now I'm giving a break over here. After this I'm going to enter the input. So my input type would be text, and my name would be the ID name over here I have used. Now since this is a required file, what am I going to do? I'm going to tell it as it is required. Okay, now whenever you are filling a form, sometimes there an example given over there, right? Like in the text box there is something written. So to give that, we use the thing, the attribute value, and we enter an example. Like if you write your name over there, you will find your name over there. I'm sorry. So this is for my name, and the same would go for the email ID if I'm not wrong. So I'm going to erase this and enter email over everywhere. Now I can write email at the rate or something like that. You can just give an example over there. Okay, now after this we are going to require a submit button, and that submit button should take all the information about these two. So for that we are going to use the input type as submit, and the name here would be submit only, right? And after this we are going to use a very important thing. Like whenever you click on a button, there is a dialog box that appears on the above. For that we use the attribute on click. Now whatever content we want to write is going to come inside the alert. Okay, like as soon as I click on the submit button, an alert box, that is a dialog box, will appear, and inside that would be this particular content. So my content would be, you will be contacted by us and thank you. Okay, I'm sorry. You will be contacted by us. Thank you. And we will save this. So let's just see how our form is going to look. Now you can style this form, you can give some particular width. You can give some particular width and height to all these input boxes. You can, sorry, it should be email over here. I have written name, okay. After this also there should be a break, and after this also there should be a break. And then let's just refresh it again. So you can see that whatever you have written inside the value has come inside this. And if you don't fill one of this thing, it would not submit. Like, let's just try. I'm saying phn@gmail.com. Okay. And I'm erasing this name and I'm going to submit. So what it is telling, please fill out this field. Now, if I enter some name as phn, okay, technology. So I'm going to submit. So you can see that the dialog box appears here that you'll be contacted by us. Thank you. So this is how you create a form. Now you can give so much styling over here. You can give some padding to this form. Then you can apply some color to the button over here. So there are so many things to be explored while creating anything. And all this styling can be done using the CSS. So here's a task. Why don't you do the styling for this particular form? And we'll meet in the next tutorial with all your form decorated. So see you in the next tutorial. Till then, please keep exploring. Thank you.
For more videos, download our app from the Play Store.